Hello, church family. It's been 7 weeks since we've been in shelter in place, and I hope this finds you well. It's hard to imagine that it's been this long since we've met on a Wednesday night, and this is a very unlikely times that no one could imagine us going through this, but we are, and I hope this finds you well. There's a couple of things that I wanted to bring to you. Keep in mind the buddy system, the buddy list we have. If you are one of those that are calling, we encourage you to keep calling the people that you've been assigned. Make sure that they're doing well and that they have all of their needs provided for. And if nothing else, just call and chat with them. People are lonely and I'm sure in need of some conversation. The other thing I wanted to touch bases with you on was the loss of some dear members to our congregation since the last time I came before you. We've lost Kelly Harris, Bert Van Holzen, and Tom Salter since we've last talked. And all three of those men are pillars of the congregation and will be sorely missed. The wisdom, the love, the knowledge that those men had will be a void and a vacuum. And so we want to keep their families in our prayers during this time. It's been, I'm sure, unimaginable that during these circumstances to lose a loved one like that. We also want to take this as an opportunity for others to step up and to get more involved and to help fill the void left by those men. They were workers until the very end. So those were men that we can all look up to and admire as strong, faithful Christian men. There are people going through the directory and calling, just going down the list and making phone calls. And I would encourage you, if you have the time and the ability to do that, just grab a directory and go through the list and just check in on people. We met the elders and the ministry staff, office staff of the church met last Friday night at the building, and it was odd to walk back in that building. It's sad that we're not able to meet as a group yet, but we're working on plans to get that going as soon as we get the clearances from the government that will allow us to do that, and we're trying to figure out the best way to keep the congregation safe physically, and then to restore the church meeting together once again. It's a difficult thing, and it's unprecedented in the point that we've never had to that's not in our playbook. We don't have a playbook for how to handle this going forward. We just making it up as we go along. There is a joy when you walk back in that building. To know that we will soon be there again. So have faith. We hope that you will stay encouraged, stay in your Bible, stay in touch with each other, and know that we don't have to be in any one specific spot to be to worship God. We are just to worship Him in spirit and in truth. But there is comfort in numbers, and we look forward to getting back to that. So I hope this finds you well, and if you are in need of anything, please reach out to the office, call the building, call an elder, call a deacon, call someone. Let your need be known, and we will do what we can to provide for you. Thank you very much.